was responsible for translating the words of Scripture into the Latin translation. Today, as we celebrate the memorial of St. Jerome, we remember our call to reflect on the Word of God. As St. Jerome reminds us, ignorance of Scripture is ignorance of Christ. So as we come to reflect on the Word of God, and as we come to receive our Lord in this beautiful celebration of Eucharist, let us prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries by acknowledging our sins. You were sent to the contrite of heart, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners, Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You were seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Nehemiah. The whole people gathered as one in the open space before the water gate, and they called upon Ezra, the scribe, to bring forth the book of the law of Moses, which the Lord prescribed for Israel. On the first day of the seventh month, therefore, Ezra, the priest, brought the law before the assembly, which consisted of men, women, and those children old enough to understand. Standing at one end of the open space that was before the water gate, he read out of the book from daybreak until midday, in the presence of the men, the women, and those children old enough to understand. And all the people listened attentively to the book of the law. Ezra the scribe stood on a wooden platform that had been made for the occasion. He opened the scroll so that all the people might see it, for he was standing higher up than any of the people. And as he opened it, all the people rose. Ezra blessed the Lord, the great God. And all the people, their hands raised high, answered, Amen, Amen. Then they bowed down and prostrated themselves before the Lord, their faces to the ground. As the people remained in their places, Ezra read from the book of the law of God, interpreting it so that all could understand what was read. Then Nehemiah, that is His Excellency, and Ezra, and the priest scribe, and the Levites who were instructing the people, said to all the people, Today is holy to the Lord your God. Do not be sad and do not weep. For all the people were weeping as they heard the words of the law. He said further, Go, eat rich food and drink sweet drinks, and allot portions to those who had nothing prepared. For today is holy to our Lord. Do not be saddened this day, for rejoicing in the Lord must be your strength. And the Levites quieted all the people, saying, Hush, for today is holy, and you must not be saddened. Then all the people went to eat and drink, to distribute portions, and to celebrate with great joy, for they understood the words that had been expounded to them. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The precepts of the Lord give joy to the heart.
The precepts of the Lord give joy to the heart.
The law of the Lord is perfect, precepts of the Lord are right, rejoicing the heart. The command of the Lord is clear, enlightening the eye.
The precepts of the Lord rejoice the heart.
The fear of the Lord is pure, enduring forever. The ordinances of the Lord are true, all of them just.
The precepts of the Lord rejoice the heart.
They are more precious than gold, than a heap of purest gold, sweeter also than syrup or honey from the comb.
The precepts of the Lord rejoice the heart.
Today, as I mentioned, the church celebrates the memorial of Saint Jerome, priest and doctor, in the early pursuit of the church, who was especially renowned for his work with Scripture. Known for his work in commenting on Scripture, but perhaps best most well known for translating all of the works of Scripture that have been completed in Aramaic and in Hebrew, bringing them together and translating them into the Latin translation, the Vulgate, the Latin translation, the Bible. For his great work, St. Jerome is often credited as the patron saint of Scripture scholars, especially of studying Scripture, because, as we heard when I said at the beginning of Mass, he is credited as saying that ignorance of Scripture is ignorance of Christ. It is in Scripture, it is in the Word of God that we truly do hear God speaking to us. And as we heard in our first reading today, in the book of Nehemiah, Ezra stands before the people of God and reads to them from the book of Moses, reads to them from the law of Moses, how they are called to come back to God, how they are called to unite themselves back to the Father. And we hear, as people hear the word of God, they begin to weep, they begin to rejoice, they begin to recognize how they are called to come back to God. It is in listening to the word of God, it is in listening to Ezra as he proclaims the word of God, the hearts of the Israelites are once again open to the presence of the Lord. And that, my brothers and sisters, is what we are called to do as well. To enter into the words of Scripture, to enter into the words of God, so that we may truly, more fully enter into our personal relationship with our loving Father. To recognize that when we hear, when we listen, when we reflect, when we meditate on the Word of God and allow it to truly enter into the depths of our hearts, that is when we enter into the fullness of our relationship with God as well. It's no coincidence that our celebration of Eucharist centers not just on the celebration of the altar, not just on receiving our Lord in the sacrament in His body and His blood, but also on listening to the Word. Two beautiful parts of our Eucharist, the liturgy of the Word and the liturgy of the Eucharist. Now, by listening to the Word of God, by preparing ourselves to enter into the sacrament, then we truly prepare ourselves to receive Christ in His body and His blood in Holy Communion. And as we reflect on that, as we receive our Lord, to then embrace the invitation that Christ gave to His disciples and gives to each and every one of us, to go forth into the world and to continue to share the good news, to share the word of God with one another. As Jesus sends forth His disciples in our gospel today, so too we are called at the end of every Mass to take what it is that we have received, the word of God, the celebration of the Eucharist, to bring it into our hearts, to be changed and transformed by it, and then to go forth and to evangelize, to share what it is that we have received with others. Today on this feast of St. Jerome, as we give thanks to God for this wonderful priest who opened the word of God for us, let us in turn, as we receive the word of God, as we receive the body and blood of our Savior, continue to be open to the changing and transforming power of our Father, embrace the beautiful call to share that good news everywhere we go.
With one voice, we turn to our all-powerful and loving God for the prayers and petitions of this community. For the Church and her leaders, may God continue to guide us in our lives of discipleship. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For elected officials, may God grant them wisdom and courage in working for the common good. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who are sick in mind, God provide healing and comfort in their time of need. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the faithful gathered here today, may the Lord make of us a community of love and service. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who have died, especially for the repose of the soul of Egmedio Ilapio, for whom this Mass is being offered, may God provide our lives rest for their souls in heaven. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear
our prayers. The quiet of our hearts, let us bring to our loving God our own prayers and petitions. For these we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Loving God, we offer these prayers of love and humility. We ask that you hear and answer them according to your will. We ask through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord, above all creation, for your goodness we have received and bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth, and work in your hands, we come to us, bread of life.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine, Lord, in your hands, we offer us our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you, for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim the death of the Lord and confess his resurrection until he comes again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer the Lord bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks to your love as worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in mercy. Welcome them into the light of grace. Have mercy on us all who pray over the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God. We may merit to be co-heirs of eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him, and O God, my Father, the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
And the Savior's command, informed by my teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, graciously grant peace in our days. God, help us in mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look now at our sins upon the faith of your church. Graciously grant your peace in the name of the Lord and to your will, who will reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign
of peace. You take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold, who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my room, but only say the word.
attentive to sacred teachings, they may understand the path they are to follow, and by following it, obtain life everlasting. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Lord, be with you.
Holy Spirit.